Hello, tiny friends, and welcome back to Tiny Keyhole Minis. I'm Jolene, and today I thought I would challenge myself to create a miniature instrument. So I chose to create the miniature fiddle. Now, you can call it a fiddle, you can call it a violin, it's the same instrument. The only difference is the way that it's played. And I'm more of a fiddle girl myself. Although I do love a mysterious violin tune. The reason why I chose to create the fiddle was because I've had that Charlie Daniels song, The Devil Went Down to Georgia, stuck in my head for days. And I thought the only way to get it out is to create a miniature fiddle and trap the song inside. Now, this is going to be mainly made of paper products. What I did was went into my Cricut program and started to construct basic shapes and manipulate them to create the fiddle shape. And then I thought, there's probably one in here. So I did a search and found one that I wanted to work with. And I just basically broke it down and cut it apart to its basic parts and what I needed. And then had my machine cut it out. So I began with eight of these basic structure pieces. And then I decided to glue them into pairs. So I'll only be gluing two pieces together at a time. Okay, so I have four pairs here, and I'm going to begin gluing two by two. Using my tacky glue, paint one side. Now, this is the first layer, and I'm going to go in with a second layer because I want it to be as black as I can get it. This is actually going to be underneath the faceplate. And the black paint is going to help those F holes seem more realistic and give it more depth. I think this looks good, tiny friends. I'm happy with the depth of the F holes, and I think three pieces are going to be enough for this body part. I'm going to add this strip for the panel, the side panel. And I'm going to glue it right to the top part of the fiddle, right? I'm going to begin right in the middle there. And this is actually where the neck and fingerboard are going to be attached to the fiddle. So it's going to cover up that seam nicely. So I'm going to take my time with this. And I'm just going to do small sections at a time because I really want this to get into every curve and nook and cranny. And once I got this side paneling completed, I realized that I forgot to double the layer and I wanted to add a double layer to this because the paper was so thin. So I decided to go ahead and lay down another strip and I'm just going to use my paintbrush to smooth down the glue and give myself a nice even surface and coat. Now the next thing I'm going to do is take my Gorilla Wood Glue and I'm going to apply it to the body part and try and create that curved body shape that this instrument has. And I'm gonna apply a generous amount of this for the first layer. I'm gonna speed this up a bit. Okay, I really hope I don't get a copyright claim for that. I'm just trying to get this song out of my head and into the fiddle. Now, this glue is almost completely dry and there are some air bubbles, but as long as those bubbles are underneath the surface, that's quite all right. But I do feel one that has made its way to the top, so I'm going to give it another layer of the glue. I'm not going to use as much for this layer, but it's going to help fill in that hole and give me a nice flat smooth surface in the end. A lot of times if I get a song stuck in my head, I'll come over here to YouTube and I'll watch the video or I'll listen to the song, and that usually does help relieve it. So for this case, I did the same thing. I came on over and I came across this claymation video. It was a music video for The Devil Went Down to Georgia, and I've never seen it before. And whoever made this video was absolutely brilliant. It was very well made. It was very creative and it was super fun. And the devil was riding a bicycle. And I'm going to stop right there. If you guys have ever seen Pee Wee Herman's bicycle, if you've ever watched the show or seen the movie, in the movie he loses his bicycle, and the whole point of the movie is him going on this adventure trying to find his bicycle. Well, it's a pretty awesome bicycle, and it's one of those vintage beach cruisers, and the devil was riding on the same bicycle, and he's riding his bicycle down to Georgia, and he crosses the Georgia state line, and he comes across little boy Johnny by the hickory stump, and he's this little hillbilly boy with a straw hat and some stitched boots. He's got his chickens dancing around. It was super cute. And the devil challenges him, and in the end, he hands over that golden fiddle to Johnny, and Johnny just kicks that fiddle back to the devil, and he was like, I don't need anything from you. He didn't say that, but you know, that's what he was like. And he just basically said, hey devil, if you ever want to come on back, you come on down and we'll give it another go. But it was so awesome, and I'm gonna put that link in the description box below if anybody wants to see that, because it was pretty fun. Here it is, and it's halfway dried. It did dry very smooth, so I'm thankful for that. It kind of reminds me of a piece of butterscotch candy, but I'm going to come back to this and work on it again. Moving on to another body part of this fiddle, I'm going to start creating the neck and fingerboard. The first thing I need to do is just cut these top parts off. Okay, having my two pieces here, I'm going to paint the fingerboard black, and I'm using a black metallic. It's a sequin black from Folk Art. And for the neck, I am using this cinnamon shade and a little bit of white, and then I'll be darkening it up just a little bit more when I'm adding the antique wax onto the piece. Okay, so my pieces are dried, and what I've done is made a pencil mark on the face plate where I want the bottom of the fingerboard to lay, and the neck will sit on top, and the fingerboard will sit on the face plate. So to figure out where I want that top part of the fingerboard to sit, I'm just going to make a pencil line on the neck part, and then I'm going to go ahead and glue it together with some tacky glue. So almost there. I'm just going to slide it down just a little bit. I'm going to move on to the tail, and these little pieces are so small. It was a challenge. Because I'm not in a good habit of using my tweezers unless I absolutely have to, so I work mostly with my fingers. I gave it a little bit of a curvature, so I actually used a paintbrush stick and just gave it some shape. And now I'm going in with that black, that metallic sequin black, but I'm going to use this for the strings. And this is actually beading wire. For the bridge, I am using a leftover piece of the scalloped trimming from the trays. And I just trimmed off a whole scallop. And I'm actually going to double this layer to give this little tiny piece some more support when I glue it down to the faceplate. Now for the tail, I don't know if you can see the opening that I created in between those layers, but that's where I'm going to put the strings. Using a piece of masking tape, this is going to help hold these strings in place so they don't move around on me. And I'm going to trim the end off nice and even and add some jewelry and metal glue by Aline's. And then just push it right in between. And now I can touch up the paint with a little bit more of that metallic sequin black. All right, tiny friends, I'm pulling out my nail embellishments and I'm going to be using these silver micro beads that I've used previously in other projects. Okay, so this is what it's looking like, and I'm going to put this aside and move on to another part. And I thought it would be a good idea to use this body part as a template, and I'm adding the tail piece on. I'm going to now create the chin rest. So I'm just going to make a little template, and I'm going to be using this leftover piece that I used previously for my umbrella tutorial and try and shape this a little more accurately. And now I have my little chin rest, and I'm also going to curve that top piece just slightly, kind of like a little slope. And then my chin rest will be completed. Okay, tiny friends, I'm moving right along here and I'm beginning to create the scroll. I actually created this shape in my Cricut program using a question mark and a circle, and I actually used another circle to cut that so that I can have the curved shape on the bottom. And I believe each side of the scroll is going to have four layers. Once those were nice and dried and completed, I took a sewing pin to create the holes in each side of the scroll for the pegs. But I did try to create two of the holes lower on one side than the other. And I'm trimming that top part down a little bit more. And I'm going to use some tacky glue for this. And I'm just going to run it right along the whole edge on one side of each scroll, placing it right on the neck piece and lining up the bottom right along where the top of the fingerboard begins. Once I got them glued on, I pinched the two top pieces of the scroll together. And I'm just going to give you a good look at what this looks like so far. I need to fill that space in along the back of the scroll. So to do that, I decided to use one of the neck pieces that I began with. And I'm just going to use a single layer on this, and I'm just going to clip off these peg pieces, going to glue it right to the top and press it right down in that nook. And I'm using tacky glue for this. And then I'm going to run it right along the top of the scroll to the back, and this piece will fill that space in on the back of the scroll. Now, I'm sorry about the light. I have a light piece on my head and I kept forgetting that I had it on. I need to go in and give it a more rounder, smoother, uniform shape. So I'm going to use my wood glue again and I'm going to run it right along on top of the strip that I just added. I'm also going to run it right on top of the seam where the two pieces are connected on each side of the scroll. To give the neck a more natural look, I ran the wood glue along both sides, and now I'm filing it down, creating a more smoother and even finish. Next, I can go ahead and add the final parts to the scroll, finishing its 3D form. So I've sliced a couple rounds off of a wooden toothpick, and I've also cut a few circles from chipboard, and I've doubled the layer on the chipboard. So beginning with the chipboard circle, I'm going to place it right in the center of the scroll, and I'm just using tacky glue for this, tiny friends. And next, I'm going to place a wooden round right in the center of that circle. Now that the scroll has all its final parts, I'm going to give it a base coat of this cinnamon shade, and then I'm going to apply some antique wax on top of that. And tiny friends, ever since I have used this combination on that antique cocktail table I created, I just cannot get away from it. The two complement each other beautifully, and that cinnamon shade makes a wonderful undertone for that antique wax. So you'll be seeing me use this combination in future projects to come. Okay, to create the pegs, I'm using pieces that I have cut from a sewing needle and a few oval shapes that I have layered together. And I'm just cutting the oval shapes in half, and I'm going to sandwich the pin in between the two pieces. So this is what it looks like, and now I'm going to paint them with the sequin black. I'll be cutting them down a lot more later on. Okay, so going back to the body of the fiddle, I have filled it in with the wood glue, and then I gave it a base coat of the cinnamon shade, and then I had to apply more wood glue on top of that to fill in the areas around the F holes. So right now I'm just filing it down nice and smooth, and it's not going to look very pretty. It's going to look like some sort of plant disease. But I did get it nice and smooth, and I touched it up with that base color, and I began to add the antique wax on top of that. Okay, I believe all the parts to the fiddle are now completed. I'm going to begin creating the bow. And I'm using a toothpick, and I have trimmed off both ends, a little more so on one end than the other. I have a few shapes here that will create the parts to the bow. I'm going to take my tacky glue and begin with the square shape, layer a few of these together to create the frog. The bow tie shape will be attached to the opposite end of the bow, and I'm going to apply this layer of wood glue all around this end of the bow to give it a more natural shape, shape it out a little more, and make the two pieces look like one entire piece. I'm painting the frog with the sequin black acrylic paint, and you may notice that I've attached a fishing line to the bow to use for the string, but the fishing line was so old and had been wrapped around its spool for ages that it was super stubborn, and I just couldn't get it to work right with me, so I removed it, and I'll be using something else in its place. Right now I'm going to wrap this little skinny strip of paper right around the bow just to give it added detail. So this is what it's looking like so far, and I've added some silver chrome paint on the very tip and also on the frog. And I will be adding more right around the edge of the frog. I'm going to use this wax thread, and I've applied some super glue to it. I just think that this is going to be a better match, and I'm taking a sewing pin to get right in that opening and flatten it out and get it attached nice and secure to the frog. Now I can add it to the opposite end. I also decided to add a few more details to the bow that you'll see in the final results. Now it is time to assemble the fiddle, and I'm going to begin with the neck and fingerboard. I did add a little bit more to the body of the neck. I sliced a round dowel and cut it in half and attached it to the bottom of the neck, and then I filled in the area where the two pieces connect with wood glue to give it a more natural shape. I'm just using some jewelry and metal glue to attach the pieces together. I also put a little bit of wood glue in there. And now I'm going to attach the bridge. Once I get the bridge on, I'm going to attach the strings, and I've added some glue to the top part just to keep them together, and I snipped off the sides at an angle so it kind of looks like a little arrow shape, and I'm just applying some metal glue right in the opening of the scroll and placing the strings inside, and then attaching the tail right to the bottom of the fiddle. Now I'm going to attach the pegs, and I'm using the metal glue, and I'm just twisting them into the holes. And for the last part, I'll be attaching the chin rest. And now I'm going to give it the final detail. And using my chalk pastels, I am just going to go in with some shading and darker tones around the whole piece. Okay, tiny friends, that was super fun. I enjoyed that. And now for the final step, I'm going to coat it with this clear enamel medium by Folk Art. And this is what it looks like. Tiny friends, I am going to buckle down and focus on that floor in the back room of the sewing room. And it's taken me some time and distraction and procrastination because there's something that I want to do to the floor that I'm trying to figure out how to do. And hopefully, I'll be able to figure that out and you'll be able to see what I'm talking about when I get to that floor. But that is definitely going to be next. I am going to put my foot down to all my miniature visions and stay focused and just ignore any visions that come in until I am done with that floor and then continue on with my miniature making. I want to thank you all for being here with me today. I hope you enjoyed this project. If so, give it a thumbs up, hit that like button, let me know what you thought in the comments below. I want to welcome all my new subscribers and thank you for joining me on my miniature journey. And don't forget to hit that like, share, and subscribe. If you do subscribe, don't forget to hit that top bell notification button to be notified every time I upload a new project. I'm going to give you a look at the final details that I added to the bow. So this is what it's looking like. I really think that this has worked, tiny friends. I believe that song has left my head and is now trapped inside the fiddle. So this is the fiddle that was made to trap the devil down in Georgia. And until next time, tiny friends, you all have a lovely day. Bye-bye.